I like how in the wide it's just like our tiny little heads above the computers.
Your phone?
Sorry, that was completely unintended. I don't know why I did that.
You kept going. When I was, you're like, sorry, that was completely. Oh wait.
When I was in high school, had a biology teacher.
She participated.
And she had the strongest Southern accent ever. And there was one day where I didn't take my ADHD medication, and I was extra loopy, and I was just like drawing during class. I wasn't paying attention to fucking anything. And I'll remember she goes, she's like, and the human body, something, something, something. She goes, and sarcomeres or whatever. And I didn't know I did this, but apparently I was just drawing. I went, sarcomeres. And like, the class just got super quiet and everybody was looking at me, but I just didn't notice because I was on another planet at that point. And she just carried on. And like, after class, my friend's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? I was like, what? I draw during class all the time.
No, I'll be with Josh. So do you mean Josh?
Felt bad. I felt really bad. She apparently just glared daggers at me and continued on.
Okay.
Oh, baby, a triple.
I don't remember anything.
I'll put some really good people with you.
I had a math teacher.
We could be on the same team.
I wouldn't zone out, but I would actually go to sleep in class. I worked at Hollywood Video, so I'd work till like 1 o'clock in the morning and then go to school the next morning. And usually my first period class was is just like,
okay,
I had no chance. I was going to sleep through it. That's what was going to happen. And I had a math teacher, I think algebra or algebra 2 or something like that, who would like purposely wait until I would fall asleep, then write a problem on the board, and then just be like, and then walk over and just like wake me up and be like, go solve it. And it just, that's the worst thing in the world, to like be dead asleep, have to wake up, and then be like, math. But if I could do the problem, she'd let me go back to sleep. When I can wake up and just walk up to the board, solve it real quick, and then go back, she'd be like, you're fine. Like, she was cool. Most of the time. Nice. I was pretty good at math. And for the most part, I would walk in, spend like the 15 minutes of the class that I was awake, like real quick, just reading from the book and learning how to do it. And then just be like, okay, do my homework, and then pass out.
I was really good at math up until pre-calculus. Something about the fact that I got to pre-cal, and my brain at that moment went, there's no fucking way you're ever going to need to know this. So, and then my brain just refused to retain knowledge on the subject.
I had the same problem. When in high school, when I got to the point that I hit the proofs, right, where it was like, you need to prove that, like, 2x equals 6, x equals 3, my brain, and most people's brains, can look at that and go, yeah, I know that's equal 3 because it's fucking right there. That's not hard. It's easy. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they always want you to, like, write out how to fully prove how you do it.
Yeah.
And in that class, it got to the point that I had a high enough grade for everything else that I could, that, you know, I was able to just leave the proofs part of the test blank.
Oh, you fucking son of
and still passed.
Wow.
So I did that because for me it was like, listen, this is the 21st century. I've got calculators. I can prove that it's right. It just takes too long. It's real annoying. So I'm not going to do that.
I remember on one of my math tests in high school, there was one problem that I only got half credit for. I was like, what the fuck? Everybody else got the same answer. I proved my work. Why did I get half credit? I go to talk to the teacher about it. She goes, yeah, so you got the right answer. You completely did not get that answer like the right way. You fucked up dividing here and doing that, and yet somehow by the grace of God, you just so happened to get the exact same answer. So technically you didn't prove the correct way of solving that problem, but I gave you luck points. You got half a point. That should be wrong. I was like, okay.
Whoa, somebody did
$1,000.
Wow. Whoa.
Kyle Devine.
Thank you very
More
much,
like
Kyle.
Divine.
That's awesome.
Divine. Yeah. All
right.
We had this one hero in economics class.
He wore a cape?
He should have. He showed up one day and had the gall in the middle of a teacher's lecture.
You can reset all my shit. Sorry.
Pull his Game Boy out and just start playing.
Oh,
so he's sitting there playing.
That is disrespectful. Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Your teachers are.
I missed the story.
This one hero, he comes to class one day and whips his Game Boy out in the middle of lecture. Just starts playing Pokemon.
Student? Okay,
yeah, student. Yeah. Just starts playing Pokemon. We were all like, what the fuck? Like, look at this guy. He is, what is this?
Ballsy.
And so the teacher is like, excuse me, what are you doing? He's like, I'm sorry, I have really bad ADD. This is how, the only way that I can pay attention is if I have something that I know is going to distract me. She's like, that's bullshit. Like, well, it was high school, so she didn't say that's bullshit, but she said that's bullshit. And so he was like, no, look, I'll next class, in the middle of it, just ask me a question. If I miss it, then I'll, like, you can send me to detention, do whatever you want. She's like, okay. So next class, like, she's sitting there, we're sitting there, she's lecturing, and completely, like, off topic of what we're talking about, he's playing the Game Boy. She goes, what's this? And it, without missing a beat, he answers.
That's awesome.
He just, like, wow. Answers it perfectly. He's like, see, I told you. She's like, well, okay. So for the rest of the year, we got to bring Game Boys to class.
Everyone did?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's awesome.
Wow.
We're, like, yeah, everybody lied. I need music to focus on work. But
we're like, it helps us study. It doesn't help us study, but
that helped him study.
Yeah.
Damn. That's nuts.
Yeah.
So.
Dog.
Bella.
And going throughout high school, the hardest things for me were always if... And for the teachers out there, you guys are doing amazing work. The thing that always made the biggest difference between if I was going to do well in the class or if I was going to do crappy in the class was just if I could find a way to equate it to something I would actually need. Like, if I can make it matter to somehow in my life, I did fine in the class. All my histories, all my sciences, I never had any problems with. And then it would come to, like, certain things in English where it's just like, the disconnect was there. And now looking back, it's like, man, I totally need those classes. And had it been, had I discovered that earlier, it would have been much better. Because those were always the classes that I actually, like, had problems with.
Yeah.
Were the ones where it was just like, this is dumb. I don't want to read Shakespeare.
I don't need it.
I remember,
stupid.
I remember hating A Tale of Two Cities for like 3/4 of that book just because it's written in Old English and I was just so frustrated. Then the last, like, the climax of that book is amazing. And it was just like, I just like, it was like pulling teeth and then suddenly like, what's gonna happen to him? Does he get with her? Like, it was, I loved that. That was great. What was like, what's like the favorite book you remember having to read for school? Mine was probably East of Eden, I think.
My favorite book that I had to read
that you were
for
required
school?
To read for school?
Either Ender's Game or 1984.
I liked Ender's Game a lot.
Catch-22.
I didn't read most of those.
Those were the only three books I read in all of high school.
Did I tell you my issue with Ender's Game?
No.
I did what there was literally a phrase discouraging you from doing. I judged a book by its cover. I got that one copy of Ender's Game that has that really, like, derpy illustration of Ender being like, like, right at camera, and it just looks really weird. And I was just like, this looks dumb. I'm not reading that.
No, that's exactly, because mine had a cool cover, and we had to pick between that or Anthem. And Anthem had a dumb cover. It was just like a candle or something.
That's dumb.
I don't know. It was like, that's dumb. That's a spaceship. I like spaceships.
Oh, man. If Ender's Game had a spaceship on it, I would have read the shit out of that.
Yeah, it had a cool spaceship.
Yeah,
I need to read more.
I read a bunch of books in high school and didn't read much of the ones the school made me read. I mean, admittedly, I just like spark noted them.
Spark notes.
I cheated most of my way through
Cliff
that.
Notes.
And it was the same problem. I mean, that was the thing. Is like, I didn't. At the time, there wasn't the connection of, like, English is important.
Yeah.
That never got made. So for me, it was just kind of like, I needed to pass high school. Mm. That was the requirement.
Yeah.
And, now looking back, I was stupid.
Oh, I'm very dumb.
It's like, if I'd have known how cool this stuff was, like, now I want to read.
Yep.
And stuff, so.
Well, the other thing is there's a lot of books that definitely caught my attention.
Oh, yeah.
There's also a lot of books that they make you read that, I mean, for me, suck.
Yeah.
I just, like Animal Farm.
I don't care. I like Animal Farm though.
A lot of people liked it. For me, it was just, I didn't care.
Sure.
Like, yeah. I just,
you can't choose what you're passionate about.
Or like Wuthering Heights. Like, I don't care about Wuthering Heights.
I never saw that.
That was a crazy one.
I didn't get you. We didn't read that.
Satan's Aliens.
We read that book means. Red Badge of Courage. That was an interesting one.
Oh, I think I did read that one, actually.
$25 per
It was interesting.
Get killed.
Not what I thought it was going to be about.
That makes so much money.
But, oh, man. I just remember in middle school, I don't know what it was about the curriculum, but, like, everything we were reading, it just so happened that, like, everything we were reading in English class was about the Holocaust around the time we learned about the Holocaust in history.
Yeah.
Like, and it was just, like, the first time I remember hearing about the Holocaust, I was like, that is, like, I couldn't even comprehend it. I was like, that's the most horrific thing I ever heard.
Yeah.
By the end of that year, I was like, I know. I get it.
Yeah. It's terrible.
I had a friend that had the nerve. I could not believe he did this. We had to write a paper on the Diary of Anne Frank. And this bold motherfucker titled the paper, I Couldn't Care Less. and immediately got 30 points docked for it. Like, wow, it was, everything else was flawless. He would have failed had the rest of the paper not been flawless. He got knocked from 100 right down to a 70 for that. He was just like, look, man, I get it. Terrible shit happened. Stop telling me. And I was like, that doesn't mean you have to be an asshole about it, dude.
There's safer ways.
Yeah. That's what, you can tell me that. We're friends. Yeah. Miss Brunel is gonna fuck your shit up. And she did.
Yeah.
Don't do that. Don't talk smack about the Holocaust.
That would have been 100.
My family probably would have disowned me.
That was real bad.
That's real bad.
We didn't learn about it.
It's just
in Australia.
Never played against them. Never played against them.
There's like
always have someone your team.
At least for me, it was like a grade. That was like,
oh, yeah.
Like they hit you. They hit like world history, and it was like there was a semester of just like, let's not kill millions of people.
Yeah,
real bad.
Yeah.
Well, it's like seventh grade we had Texas history, and then eighth grade was Holocaust history. World history, but let's skip all the early parts and
just wait to Holocaust. It wasn't even the war. It was just.
Well, no, I mean it was everything.
I mean it was the war, but it was like mostly just
focused on that.
Yeah, how bad this thing sucked.
I didn't know much at all about. The Holocaust, even up to before I moved here, until I watched a documentary called Auschwitz. Which I'm sure is one of many. And I was like, whoa, that was, I had no way. And I think it's incredible that I could live in a country like Australia and not know anything about it. But I don't know. We're kind of new.
I assume that one of the reasons we know so much about World War II or taught so much about World War II is because America is able to point back that and go, remember when we were awesome and it was like unanimously decided that America was awesome? That was great. Let's not forget those times. What's the Gulf War? Like, that's what I assume. Don't talk about Vietnam that much. That was our bad. But remember the Golden Age. I don't know. That's my theory.
That makes sense.
A simpler time.
Yeah, we are.
Let's talk about all these stuff that the other people did bad stuff. Like, yeah.
We're a relatively young country still.
I gotta get back to work. I'll return.
In when you compare it to some of the, you know, the other.
Oh, yeah, for sure. When Jack went to England, he came back and he said there were buildings older than. Not only America, but older than when Columbus allegedly, like, not allegedly, sorry, that was a stupid word to use, but when Columbus came to
what
America.
What are they teaching you guys going back?
Allegedly.
We don't know if he found the country or
don't
not.
Don't know.
I want to give a shout out to whoever donated $3.33 and titled themselves Oh Baby a Triple.
Oh Baby.
You're my favorite donor.
I have to look at it. I need to watch that video.
It's so bad.
Well, I have to. I don't understand. I don't understand anything.
Stop it.
Oh, you weren't talking.
Are you guys winning?
No, not even remotely.
Are you playing the community?
They even invaded an arena.
It's because we're down.
Oh yeah.
You and I are out.
We would have won if it had been all of us.
When could we?
Can you please do me a favor?
Yes.
Can you please pass me? There's like a lip balm thing.
Give up.
That too, but there's.
when can you surrender?
1:20.
Thank you.
10 minutes.
You can't surrender to the community.
Listen, Adam, if you saw what this game was doing to us.
What's the... Oh!
Don't even look cold on the shape.
Oh, wow.
He yelted out.
Well,
I think I played 5 minutes and then quit the game. Because I think I was upsetting Jack because I was sucking so bad.
I'm really competitive.
From watching the stream and seeing what we're going to build.
Basically, me and my wife don't play games together at all. She doesn't like video games to begin with, but even if she did, it would be a thing like that wouldn't be an option just because I'm really vocal and I'm really competitive. So it's like I'm one of those people that like
kidding.
Oh, my wife says offset. I'm an asshole. The way I play games, I am. I'm competitive. You know, I'm not quite the crazy raid leader that you see videos about, but I'm the guy who, like, you know, if someone really does mess up, I will call them on it. And myself, you know, I'll call myself on it as well. But it's like, that's a part of playing games competitively is knowing when you fucked up and when it's your fault and when you need to... Like, when you need to get better. So basically, me and my wife, the only games we ever play together are, like, Mario. Things that are just, like, really casual. And just
See,
like,
I'm
you just gotta
super
jump.
Competitive.
And even then, like, there's a couple Mario games that, like, we wouldn't play together.
There's some Mario games, like, What have you done? Yeah. You've murdered me.
Right. Yeah, no, I'm like that with Mario. Yeah. Like other games, like multiplayer games, I'm less like I guess it's because I don't take it seriously.
Yeah.
That I'm just like, oh, okay, cool. I'll just respawn and whatever. But really, it's a very detrimental thing to the team. I don't take it very seriously. But Mario Kart, oh my gosh, do I take that seriously?
Mario Kart puts a divide in our household. Me and my roommate and his girlfriend. It's like we can't talk to each other after a Mario Kart session. Where we go to our separate rooms and just like.
Have you ever had that moment with one of your friends when you're playing Mario Kart? Or the first time this ever happened to me was Smash Bros. I was sitting next to one of my best friends. We were playing Smash Brothers, and there's that moment when like when you're losing and they're talking trash, and it's like you actually feel yourself like violently angry. Where it's just like, I can't talk to you. It's like you need to leave.
Yeah, it's like
because I'm mad. You're wow.
You can ask Stan. I get that, like that about FIFA. Yeah,
that about FIFA.
Yeah, my brothers get that way about FIFA as well.
Like I just get really quiet, and Stan goes, "You're really scary when you play FIFA." I'm just like, "No, I'm not mad."
That's when you know it's just like I need to stop.
Yeah,
talking trash.
Yeah.
Suddenly Cole's really quiet.
Yeah,
it's really bad.
But then he and Jordan keep going. That's the problem. That's the problem.
I could have sworn there was like a $200 donation, and I can't find it.
Don't look anybody.
They hate this place so much.
Is that 40-8?
No, Debbie Bordero, thank you for $100.
Wow.
No, I mean
Jesus
the top.
Jesus Christ, really?
Hey, you guys finished up the match.
Wow.
I'm proud of you.
I tried to split us up into two teams. But was it? No, everybody had the same team, so that we were just against community.
Did you just get hard countered?
Huh?
Did you get hard countered?
Yeah, you know, bad stuff. We got bad stuff.
Yeah.
All right. Whoever's back in the control room, don't cut to my screen right now. I'm logging in. So. All right,
we'll do another one.
All right, Periscope.
What?
Mark Ruffalo.
Oh, wow.
The Hulk tweeted about us?
I love Mark
Holy
Ruffalo.
Crap, Mark Ruffalo, you're the best. He seems like the nicest dude.
He does seem
I
want to
party
like the
with that dude.
I want to hug him.
He retweeted someone saying, "Hey, Mark Ruffalo, Rooster is doing a 24-hour stream for charity. Mind a retweet to spread the word for the kids. Hashtag RT Extra Life." So
That's
he retweeted
awesome.
That. Thanks, Mark Ruffalo. And thank you to Anna Garcia, who's at Let's Avenge, who tweeted that to him.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
At Let's Avenge.
Yeah.
And that goes to show you. So even if you can't donate, even if you don't have the ability to donate, you can always spread the word through tweets and Facebook messages and just sharing with your friends and stuff like that can happen, which like obviously Mark Ruffalo has a pretty big reach. And so now get your message spread out and get our message spread out. Yeah. That's pretty amazing. So thank you very much. Feel free. If there's other celebrities out there and you want to tweet them, be polite. Don't be a jerk. And say, you know, please let us spread the word. So thank you very much, everyone. Thank you, Mark Ruffalo, if you are watching. Which I know you are.
I
know you are.
Until like only people.
All right.
I want to be best friends.
John, you're level 6. I'll play you.
Yeah, you could be on the other team. you want to do another arena? Or do you want to do like assault something different?
I think arena. I want to do arena. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
But well, let's split ourselves up.
Okay, so we'll split up.
Yeah.
Okay. I think we're just good. Barbara and I have to split up.
No, John, you and I.
Are. They don't play. They don't play.
We did good. We did fine.
I did fine.
Yeah.
That's a great adjective.
All right.
Joel Rubin is Jew shaming me on Twitter. I don't appreciate.
Jew shaming.
He didn't know. It's because I didn't know what that scarf thing was called.
Did he know?
Apparently.
Of course he knew.
Because he's a better Jew than
there you
I
go.
Am.
Wait,
well, he is Jew House.
Barbara, is there
you?
Is there a
I'm
class?
I'm 89.
Okay. He's like right, level 99.
We've got 30s on our team, and we have you got 30s on your team.
Who works at high res?
That's Chris.
How do
Shout
I
out to Chris from Hi-Rez.
The item's auto. Is that on the next screen?
Yes.
Okay. Well, Katie found that video.
Cole's fucking losing.
Katie's losing it. She's doing the quiet laugh.
Oh god, yes! She watched it.
Okay.
Yeah, she watched it.
What? Oh, that's
the
triple.
The triple.
Oh, but you're in the other
team. I told you.
It's like Mr. Macy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Can do.
Can do. Oh my God. I am Mr. Macy.
All right. How are we doing on donations, Katie? We're at almost 10,000 posters.
It's true. I wasn't.
Wow.
I was gonna tell you when we got to 9,500.
Oh, sorry. I'm just looking at the screen.
Is that a
oh baby! God,
baby, a triple!
Oh baby!
Oh baby!
Yeah.
Oh, baby. All right, now I can.
I just
want to
thank
can...
Stan for that video.
Now I can. Now I get the references.
Okay.
How you doing? Are you okay?
Good. Yeah.
Long day?
It's been a long day, so my energy level is actually pretty high. Oh! Dog.
It's yes.
So, Rebel.
Careening.
Hey.
Oh, goodbye.
Another dog.
Hey, you two. Rebel, come here.
Tiny dog.
Hey. Relax.
Hi. I am Rebel.
Just chill.
Give me
where's your other dog?
Does it take a minute? She's at home.
Why is she at home?
Let me get to level
because allowed. Say it like that. I trust my dog not to break things too badly.
Oh yeah, just a little bit badly.
Just a little, you know, unplug some stuff. He'll be fine.
Knock some things over.
Sky will be one. Oh, you're asking for it, Cole.
Oh, gross.
He just was like, "Hi, I'm out of here."
Yeah. I gotta lick daddy. You gotta lick daddy. Ew.
We're a little over $185,000.
That's
awesome. I don't
have
a jump button. Jump is useless in that game.
$185,000. That's all. So we are rapidly approaching where we at. I think we were at 185 last year at like 4 a.m.
Yeah, it was late.
So yeah,
in the home stretch.
Yeah, we had a nice surge at the very end.
I can't imagine what it's going to be like when Michael and Gavin get here.
It's going to be chaos.
And fun house.
When are they scheduled? At 4? 5?
Fascinated.
What's that?
Michael and Gavin, I think, is 6?
They're coming in, I think, 8 till 10.
Are they 8 till 10? Okay.
I think.
8 till 10?
Yeah.
Fun house is
From 6 till 8.
Soon.
Okay. Yeah. So from basically 6 till midnight, it's going to be pure chaos. So this is our chance to kind of catch our breaths.
Yeah.
And then it's all going to go.
Make sure everything is working.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's all going to go
and
nuts.
And then the roller coaster begins.
Mm-hmm.
Rebel. Red.
Yeah, so, we were up to about 3 last night.
What were we up to 3-4?
Just finalizing some site updates, making sure that the
could handle
homepage had the feeds and had the donate links. All the store was ready. We had a bunch of extra servers we spun up just to make sure we could handle it. You guys still crashed at 8:00 this morning.
Yay, we did it.
Everyone was like constantly refreshing, waiting for it to go live. So it just like melted the system.
That's awesome.
And then.
Should we remind people they could also watch on the app?
They can also.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The app works as well.
You can also order from the app. You can order a poster from the app. It's really cool.
Yep.
Yeah,
the store
can buy the poster.
Minions in the middle.
You can buy posters.
Yeah.
Good to know. Thank you,
John. You can open, you know, you can donate through, not through the app, but the links will work from the Twitter feed that's in the app.
There you go.
Awesome.
So, yeah.
And Barb, do we have any... like people's journals on the site
Aries.
That you look at.
Get on Aries.
Yeah.
Yep.
Jack has one on the front
Jack
page. We also have a Facebook event that people could find information from as well. I think that's on the Rooster Teeth Facebook page.
Doing great.
So if they want to go there, they could see it.
Pretty good.
We've been checking in on the app basically around the office as we've been
so I feel like
watching.
Part of that.
That dog is as tall as you.
Yeah, big dog.
Big boots.
Sky's bigger than he is.
Really?
Yeah. He's stockier, but Sky's taller already.
Wow. Get off me.
That's nuts.
Yeah, she's
going
to be enormous.
Pyrenees?
And she's not done. Enormous. She won't finish growing for another 6 more months.
God.
Skywalker is his size at 10 months old. She's going to be a horse.
Can we ride her around?
Saddle.
Throw a
saddle.
Probably. Yeah. Well, her back is she's got a pretty significant arc in her back.
Perfect.
So perfect. Yeah, it'd be great for riding, bad for dog backs. They're not really supposed to do that, so
fine.
We kind of have to watch her for that one. It's kind of prone for dogs. I mean, she's a great Pyrenees mix. So dogs that size, you know, they're kind of prone to have some goofy issues that you gotta watch out for.
Ah.
Rebel had a shoulder surgery when he was young.
I remember that.
So, what does that mean?
Yeah, Rebel, you like the butt scratches?
Go.
Yeah, buddy.
Body blocking you. Okay, you're good.
All right, I've jumped into some Destiny now as well, so.
Hey, we're winning.
Someone was aiming for you.
That's the raid gun.
Is that an old?
Oh, those guys are female already.
Yeah.
Yes, this is the raid gun, and also, oh, that's not the raid gun.
No, but that looked like 1,000-yard stare.
That was 1,000-yard stare.
It's really sad that I can look at these guns and without looking at them be like, oh, that's 1,000-yard stare. That's, you know, yeah, that's great. Is that the auto rifle?
Mm-hmm.
Stan, do your
Do you
job.
Like the raid auto rifle?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, you're the only person I've met.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of people shit all over the raid auto rifle. I like the raid pulse rifle a lot. I like the bounce pattern on it is really, really great.
So I'm supposed to go fight the flares, and I can't get over there. Like, I'm literally stuck. Like, I can't get past the door.
Literally, the character you are did what you can do.
That's a wall, right?
Yeah. Probably gonna go back.
Yeah. No, like the door you go through, like this is the, See, there they are over there.
Did you join?
I joined late. Like, they're already,
oh, you joined
already
a late game?
Speaking of joining.
Can you just kill yourself real quick?
Maybe.
Jump off a cliff or something?
Oh, that sounds good.
Grenade yourself? What'd you say?
Do it, Katie.
The spiel.
The spiel.
If you have just joined us, we are about, how long are we through? We're 3, 4.
We're about a third of the way through, I think.
One third of the way through our 24-hour extra live stream.
Oh, Rebel.
Rebel back.
You bastard.
With Rebel the dog.
Was that a cider?
No, it was just a can of Coke. I don't even think it, did it go on the ground? Oh, wait, no, that one went on the ground.
Go.
We have paper towel somewhere.
Yeah, it's all good.
Oh, it's here, behind Cole.
Oh, yeah, again. There we are. Some there, too.
Thank you.
Oh, dogs.
Dog. They're everywhere.
That's dog.
Bella.
Oh. That's a girl. Right in the mic.
He, like, cut to me for 2 seconds. Oh, Bella, don't walk. Oh.
Gotcha. Hi, Bella.
So we're about a third of the way through our 24-hour stream, raising money for Children's
Bella's
Miracle.
Not quite, I'm sorry.
It's okay, network hospitals. Rooster Teeth is specifically fundraising for Dell Children's Medical Center of Central Texas, which is just a stone's throw away from our set here. You can buy a poster, the exclusive Pokemon poster, which we've got up behind me, there it is, right there. So awesome. All the staff have been turned into their Pokemon selves.
That's so cool.
That's exclusive to Rooster Teeth. It's $10 on the store. You can purchase it on the international store. Unfortunately, it's not available through the Australia and New Zealand or UK stores. You'll have to switch, when you're on the website, you'll have to switch to the international store and buy it through there. All proceeds for that will go directly to Dell Children's Hospital, which is really awesome. It'll go on top of the money that we've already raised online. If you would like to donate, please do so at roosterteeth.com/donate or through the Extra Life link, which is extra-life.org. And you can find Rooster Teeth there. And donate to one of us. If you haven't signed up already and you would prefer to donate to a different hospital, you absolutely can do that. Children's Miracle Network hospitals span all over America and Canada. I was just thinking if it had gone international, and I don't think it has. So yeah, it's America and Canada, which is really awesome. So you can choose a hospital that's closer to you and donate directly to them. You can even join the Rooster Teeth team, and that will go to our overall goal, which would be really cool. But you don't have to do that. So thank you so much for joining us. We're doing Smite right now, and everyone is very serious and very involved.
We're being respectful for your speed.
No, I mean, even before that, you were very involved. We keep getting like $1 donations, which I assume is every time you kill someone. So
we all died.
We're also joined by Rebel the dog and Bella the dog. What have we got coming up next, Jack?
For the
schedule? I talk like Obama.
I'm not sure.
I'll look it up.
Yeah.
Sorry. I actually think I have it up. Hang on. Because I'm using your laptop. It's Ryan. Wait, no. Did we move Ryan? Or is this the updated one?
Why am I not doing my special stuff?
Is it Ryan and Meg next?
Yeah.
Cool.
That's right.
So that's the updated one.
The no cruise is
cool. So Ryan, Meg, and Ashley will be joining us in about half an hour.
Gone soon.
Except Ashley.
I think they're just kind of hanging out.
Hanging out, playing Nintendo. we have sold over 9,500 posters.
That's awesome.
9,500 posters.
What was that?
25,000 posters this year, so we are well
that
on
is
our
way
right now.
Our goal, and we've raised over nearly $186,000 just on the Extra Life side, which is just unbelievable. With our goal being $300,000, so we're more than halfway there.
$300,000 with 2,500.
Yeah. So our Extra Life goal is 300.
Half a million mark.
If we get 25,000 posters, and we do 300,000 on the stream, that will be our half million mark.
Yes. Awesome. Yeah.
Which is our ultimate goal.
That is our ultimate.
So are you shaving all of your beard?
Mm-hmm.
Like gone. Like 2002 Jack.
Yeah, so like.
Wait, mustache. Change.
Like straight out of high school. Yeah, it's all going off.
Wow.
Yeah, it's going to be terrible.
Yeah.
Where is the.
Katie, how do you feel about this?
I'm doing it.
The. Have you ever seen him without a beard?
No.
Are you worried that you're going to fall out of love with him?
It'll grow back, right? Right?
When, I mean, yeah, but for like.
She's gonna have to take a vacation.
For a number of months, you're gonna be like, "Who's this strange man in my bed?"
Yeah, he'll wake up every morning like, "Oh my god!" I'm kind of excited because Jack actually has never seen his dad without a mustache.
Yeah.
So I at least want to be able to tell my children I've seen what your dad's face looks like without a beard.
I know what your dad looks like.
Yeah.
Underneath all
you have
hair.
His chin because I've seen it. I know.
At some point, it did exist under there.
So, I would like to be able to say that.
Nice.
Yeah, a beard little, wig.
Just in cool. case.
He has a beanie that has like a beard attached to it, yeah, which is really funny. And now you can actually use it. If you guys want to tweet questions, we have Adam and Barbara and John, and who can I not see?
Stan
from the Gauntlet! And Cole.
And
Jack and Bella and Rebel,
and
if you want to ask them questions.
Rebel answer questions. He likes food.
Thank you, everyone,
his
for...
long walks in the neighborhood. He likes swimming.
We're trying to get Emma to like swimming, but we haven't tried very hard.
Yeah. Duncan said we could throw her in his pool.
Mm-hmm. So Ellie likes swimming.
The,
like, oh, not swimming,
in,
but...
in our neighborhood yet?
Mm-hmm. Not yet.
We should go together
we
at
should
some
have
point.
Because
Rebel's
date.
An idiot. Rebel will swim to the middle. Oh. And then, just, like, he'll chase ducks across the pond, no problem.
Awesome.
That's scary. You guys closing the gap? I've been learning about off-leash walking because I'd like to be able to take Emma to like an open park and be able to take her off the leash. So, but I have to find one of those gigantic long leads where I can let her go away.
When
and
you start
then,
to train her,
right?
Yeah, Rebel can do off-leash, and he'll be right by my side if I whistle, if I call him.
Awesome. Even if like there's stuff going on around you, that's cool.
So I might have to actually, if there's a distraction, I'll probably have to call him by name.
Mm-hmm.
But I've had him with other dogs. Like, where he's been interested.
Right.
Hey!
Emma's thing is she gets too distracted.
Yeah.
Like, something else will just, like...
Yeah, no, with Rebel with other dogs, he'll be distracted, but if I actually call him by name and use a certain tone, he'll be like, okay, I gotta stop doing what I'm doing. Gotta come this direction.
No, Emma's just oblivious to everything.
A lot of those,
she sees something shiny, she's gone.
I think it's because like she, like the adrenaline goes through her and it clouds her.
Yeah.
She just her.
Rebel
attention.
Had that problem for a long time until I started bringing him to the office every day,
mm-hmm.
where he was around other dogs mm-hmm. every day. I mean, you know, like Bella's around here somewhere, and so is Rebel. It wasn't until Rebel learned that like there are going to be other distractions that happen constantly, and even when that happens, like. I still have to listen to me.
Right.
Oh, the poster fell.
No.
John!
So pictures do exist.
That's not even...
And it's also the face, too. I don't know why Mouse Tales. Also, I think I really love that movie. Is that the one with the cheese?
That's actually a book about... So that photo is from an event this guy named Jim Hill did. It's Jim Hill Media. He does a lot of behind the scenes of Mickey Mouse... Or behind the scenes of Disney World. And so he had an event in Orlando where it was like he was giving, this is super, super nerdy, but he was giving like, you know, he was talking about secret stuff about Walt Disney World and what happened there and like mm-hmm. cool behind the scenes facts about Walt Disney and all sorts of things.
Is this where you got a book as well?
That's what that book was. Yeah, I won that.
Sorry,
yeah.
I thought it was a movie.
Why is the warm-up not coming down?
I think you look like David Tennant without a beard.
Have we mentioned what Reddit tweeted at us?
There it
Reddit
I said
like challenged us.
Oh yeah, yeah. Reddit challenged our supremacy in the extra life donation game. Ooh. So we've gotten more donations than anyone else the last 2 years of extra life, and they claim they're gonna beat us this year, which I would love to see them try. Good luck, Reddit.
That's like the best thing, because even if they do beat us, it's like good
job. Yeah, exactly.
More money for children.
Yeah.
Geek
and Sundry, I think, is our only. Right, like the only real close team right
and
now.
Oh yeah, they also
KB
did their stuff
mod?
Already. They're already done.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, KB Mod and the Internet Famous. They always have big ones. Can you look on Extra Life and see what the other teams are looking like right now?
I thought they removed their top standings on Extra Life.
I think they're still there.
Let me find a good question to ask while I look that up. Someone said, can you say Xbox off to see if anyone learned from last year? That was actually a funny moment.
So Twitter wants me and Jack to talk hockey.
Really?
Yeah, I saw that about the Jack. Dallas Stars.
Okay.
All right, you guys do that while I look.
Stars doing well this year.
Stars are doing really well.
No one asked for Cole.
Yeah, Cole. No one wants you,
Katie,
Cole. Katie
keeping me in line.
I'm sorry.
Katie's
keeping me in line. It's weird. So
I don't have friends, and I can't talk about hockey.
I haven't.
Can't talk about hockey.
Yeah.
Was it McDavid or was it Eichel that just like broke his hip?
I think it was
McDavid.
Do you know Cole?
I always feel bad because like every time, so every year during the draft, there's always like this big huge commotion for like two players, and I always feel like it's overhyped, and I always feel like it's just the same crap that happens every year where they're like, oh, it's generational talent, the next Crosby, the next, And it's just like, guys, they're 19. Like, we have no idea if they're even going to be remotely close. And now, like, this guy broke his hip. Yeah.
Yeah.
Connor McDavid is currently out on an injury, and it's like, it's not a small injury.
No,
it's like, he could be, like, done for months and months and months, if not like the season.
I mean, that's at least 6 weeks just for the injury to recover.
And then he has to get back to like playing shape.
Yeah.
No, but it's crazy. He got injured. I think it was like the seventh or eighth game.
Wasn't that the right circle?
And it's just like, you know, he's triple A talent, and I feel bad because it's like this is the year that he gets to start really making his name.
Mm-hmm.
At the NHL level and stuff like that, and to kind of get snuffed out so early,
yeah.
You know, he's not even gonna have the opportunity to do a full, you know, arc of growing and getting better for the first, you know,
it's just
5
years just
or
like,
something. It just makes it that much more difficult going forward now.
Yeah,
you know, because I mean, if he's out like 8 weeks, that's like 20, like 15 games. He's gonna miss points out, so he's immediately, you know, a mid-tier scorer.
It's not
score.
Make or break, but it's a good majority of the season.
Yep, it's crazy. But yeah, Dallas is doing real well. I'm a Dallas fan myself, so that
Montreal is doing really good too, right?
Yeah, that's it's really funny. The subreddits are really, really don't like the Dallas Stars.
Yeah,
and I'm convinced it's because there's a little team from Texas doing as good as the Canadians.
Well, the Stars were huge back in the late 90s? Or?
Yeah, it's also crazy because the Arizona's doing really well.
The Coyotes.
The Coyotes.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, come on. There's been a couple. Like this year's really, really good. The Central Division is intense.
Yeah.
Like, every single team is, like, super triple A. It's crazy.
Very competitive, yeah.
What are you saying, kid?
I don't know where to find that information. I know it exists, but I can't find it anymore.
What information?
Who's coming first? Every time I click on it, it takes me to just our
program. Why, hello.
There should be a sheet open right now that's the schedule.
Wait, what?
Hey, it's Jeremy Dooley.
Hey.
People who are winning. Like,
what?
Like,
oh, I don't know. Someone was saying they may have taken it down, so it might actually be up anymore.
Oh, yeah. I remember. Yeah,
taking it down. What is happening?
I also remember John was telling me that.
Well, it's still a little bit left. All
right.
This week, today is On the Spot's birthday.
Hey.
Hey.
Yeah.
John.
Happy birthday on the spot.
So, yeah, right now we are the top team, the 187K.
See, mine says we're the second top one.
Well, no, that's on the home.
The second top one?
If you click on top.
You mean second?
No, the second top.
The second number one.
Sorry, where am I going?
If you click on the top, or if you click on the actual, hang on, let me go back.
Yeah, if you could tell me how to get there.
So, do you see the little banner that says top fundraisers?
No. Where should I be? Where are you?
All right, let's take a look. I'm on the phone, so maybe the PC is like looks different. All right, so go to justextralife.org.
What's up, stream?
The Duelmeister's back.
Jeremy's back.
Duelmeister General.
How does your mouth feel?
Yeah, how are your lips?
Dude, I went home and...
Oh, did you guys kiss?
Yeah, hey, Matt. Uh-huh. I went home, I brushed okay. I brushed my teeth, and then I ate a whole cheesecake.
Forever now.
Hey, Matt, props to you for just going in for it.
Yeah, you went for it. Matt was all like,
as soon as you guys said it, I was like, this is happening.
Yeah,
I was like,
that's what you gotta do. Like, when the whole truffle shuffle thing at the panel at RTX that one year, I was just like, I gotta do it. I can't not do this
now. You can't say no, disappoint everybody.
And also,
I just disappointed myself instead.
Exactly.
But that's only one person out of 6 billion.
Exactly. And I had to make Jeff pay a grand.
Crushing Reddit.
Yeah.
Sorry,
that's worth it.
Right, crushing Reddit.
Yeah, would you?
Thank you, Adam.
Close game.
It's like,
yeah.
Would you
so
pay
that page will be is the standings for the top teams.
Nice. Because I knew we had one because we put the Rooster Teeth logo on it,
and now
so I knew it existed.
When you're winning.
Oh, yeah. You guys could cut back to my screen
well,
right now.
Well, technically, we would have won either way because there was Rooster Teeth logo.
This is very true.
What are they?
Wait. Smite. So, Josh, what was your standing?
One.
You want to jump in? You can slide
zero
that over there.
Wait, zero kills?
Yeah.
So it's not like
what are you
doing point right eight.
I'm just doing Vanguard strikes.
Zero and eight. That's a good game on my history. Great. Good thing it doesn't like negatively affect anything.
Dude, Jackie got a legendary Engram.
So many.
Apparently, sleeper stimulant. Is available today.
Oh, it is?
To start the quest line. So I've got to go home and
load
that start that quest line.
I got mine. I haven't upgraded at all. Oh, there we go.
I was,
do work.
I was out of town when the first quest started, so I missed it.
Ah.
And, like, I think I'm one of the only ones in my group that doesn't have it.
I just got, I got
really bitter about it.
I got Touch of Malice really late, and I finally got it, so I'm excited
to. I still have to go collect the stupid calcifieds.
I, sense. Caleb a video recently of me using the sleeper simulant. Game fails. I fired at an ogre, went through the ogre, bounced four times, and came back and killed me.
That killed you?
Yeah, to kill me instantly.
Aw.
I never, wow, I didn't even know that could happen.
I got
you're getting a lot of marriage proposals on Twitter, Jeremy.
Like, tweet me if they saw it.
I think they're really into you from that.
Wait, what's going on?
Chris from High Res is going to be emailing me some Ultimate God Pack codes and gems.
Oh, nice.
Awesome.
Giveaways.
Badass.
Oh, sweet.
I think it's time we do another giveaway.
We should.
It is about that time.
Give it away, give it away, give it away.
Holy shit. What? Since...
What?
Wow. She's that super freaking awesome
Naomi.
Lady
she's
that made
awesome.
The...
It's Naomi.
Makes the plushies.
Naomi, I just saw your plushie thing you made of Panadian.
Awesome.
Which is my Pokemon. That's
she
incredible.
Said it's number three, so I'm going to look at the others.
It's not on my
that's why I was at home.
Oh, okay.
He's done.
Yep, I was just enjoying my time.
And Babunzi?
Let me wipe off my germs.
Babunzi?
Yeah.
Man, she is cracking them out.
I'm sorry.
They're amazing.
I've been having a runny nose, so.
Gross, Barbara.
Don't remember if I
some of our community is weird, guys.
Cole's like, all right, sweet.
Weird. Right,
we're
going to
play another custom game
with
the chat room.
It's weird,
just
man.
Weird.
Just regular weird.
Anything in particular this
no,
time?
No, not even worth talking about on the stream. There are too many microphones nearby.
Wait, I'm going to sign out.
There's no way you can be.
For me?
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's after I masturbate, right?
You know, I say things about our community being really weird, and then she, like, she immediately responds with just, like,
she's wide
raising the bar.
Yeah.
I guess that's true. Yeah, you started there.
That's what I want. There's no room.
I was born.
I did it.
What's the quote?
Uh-oh. Rebel!
Hey, buddy.
Rebel.
I don't even care.
She's put her phone on the ground. I'm doing terrible right now.
Okay, here's a pretty simple one. If you could be any animal, what would you be? What would it be and why?
Probably a hawk. Or what's the, is it a falcon? What's the bird that like purposely flies like super high in the air and then just like dive bombs going straight down?
Turkey.
Falcon? Yeah, I'd be a falcon. That
pretty
sounds
sure it's
awesome.
Turkey.
Wait,
falcon?
What?
No, what animal?
If you could be any animal, what animal would you be?
I would be rebel.
Bald.
Look how happy
it is, like the happiest animal on the planet.
Being a domesticated dog would be a pretty plush life.
Yeah.
No, being a domesticated cat, because then you can just
do
whatever you want and still not have to do anything.
Yeah.
So you don't have to do anything.
A domesticated cat. That's a really good answer.
It's like, I don't know if that's my final answer, but.
But it's a good one.
You don't have to
do I have to tell Aaron
about
what's going on?
Where's my dog?
Stan Mosby.
Panda.
Come here, bud.
Panda?
Yeah, I love pandas.
Because you don't want to have sex?
Bella!
Bye-bye.
Oh! Oh! Yeah.
Damn!
That's exactly why.
Sorry.
Wait, Katie, what would you be?
What would I be?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm gonna
say something
it's
like
it's a strange combination, but I would either be a bear or a dolphin.
Hey, someone find my dog.
You can't make fun of that, Stan.
What are the reasons between them? Those aren't even close.
No. What do you guys think?
I guess it's difficult. A bear because they're, I think they're grounded.
Yes, they are on the ground.
Well, just, anyway. And a dolphin because they're majestic, I think, and they're intelligent. And
Have you seen some of the documentaries on dolphins? Because majestic is true, they're also fucking evil.
Yeah, they're especially
terrifying
in groups.
Monsters of the ocean.
They're very calculated, yeah. Yes. But I put that to their intelligence, their ability to.
So anything
out.
That's intelligent just inherently at some point becomes evil.
I think so.
I guess history does speak.
Okay, yeah, I think so.
Sure did.
I would agree with that. Barbara, what would you be?
Selma the
animal.
Mm-hmm.
I
keep forgetting to do my three coins.
Yeah.
So I could just like.
I'm
just sloth around.
I'm just an idiot.
But they get to just like hang out.
They're like, oh,
or like what
branch.
Was. I think an
owl would be a good
Timon and Pumbaa. That was
right.
A meerkat, right?
Yeah, Timon's a meerkat.
Like they're pretty happy. Or they look kind of happy. I assume they're happy.
At least they look kind of happy in that one movie.
Well, I mean, when you go to the zoo and they're like all like, what's going on, guys?
Your nemesis.
You're an assassin.
It's a condor, someone said.
What mods do you have on 1,000 yen?
Not many. I literally, I just got my,
Okay, so this one's a, you found this one. This one's not bought.
No.
So you don't have mulligan?
No.
Or, triple tap? Mm.
Someone said it's a condor. The bird.
A condor?
Mm-hmm.
Condors are huge, though, right? Don't they have, like, a 6-foot wingspan? I mean, I guess that's accurate. I'm sort of enormous, but.
I remember learning in school about albatrosses, and that blew my mind.
Albatross.
Yeah, like how
they got big wings.
They got big wings.
You want to join my fire team?
I have to sneeze.
Sure, why not?
Ult shoots them up in the air. Like, that's what eagles, hawks,
and... Oh, yeah? So, all, do
so
all
technically,
of those
it's
do that?
True.
It's just one lane. Yeah. Single lane.
That's like the family.
Andrew, pan!
Charge somebody and knock them up in the
that's
air,
awesome.
And then they fall down.
Yeah, I watched a documentary like, when I was a kid about the birds that, like, they'll go up to like 3,000 feet or some number that's tall. I don't actually know if that's. Way
just
up there.
Wanna,
seems like it.
You're
and then they
wing,
just like
so you're trying to take down
they
the
just curve their wings
in,
and then
the
just
tower area,
dive bomb
the tower
on other flying creatures,
so just kind
of
and we'll take
it.
Them out of the air.
If they're attacking tower, attack tower. If not, attack teammates.
Yeah.
Wow. Just jump in.
That's awesome.
Who's playing Smite? Who's got like refrigerators on their arms?
That's me. Can you see how buff I am?
Have you not seen some of the new gods?
No.
There's a.
If they're servers, not refrigerators.
Are they really?
All right, let's calm down. They're refrigerators.
I don't know. Those look like refrigerators to me.
That's funny.
I have address.
Isn't that like Kolika? It's a K,
it's
right?
Kabrakin.
No,
there is no going back.
Oh, boy.
What does this thing do over here?
Get close to me. Get close to me.
It's when you die, you fall asleep.
Don't stand
that's how many
so
hits you
close to me.
No, it's stand close to me. I'll heal you.
As well?
Don't stand
so for a while,
she did.
I got three ones because my eyes were dying, and I wanted to play Rock Band and be able
so,
to read the words.
When I say come close to me, come close to me.
What is my little
strong? I keep trying to see
it. Yeah, you're made. No, you're not.
It's just photos of like two beards like mashed together.
You guys look like you're embracing. Like, it's... It's
you
seductive.
Don't need to make it more intimate. It was already a pretty weird moment.
Yeah,
sure.
They do.
Yeah, it was.
Oh, but they don't lead to the wing. But they do matter because
we're all friends.
Check up on poster sales.
Don't stand.
Let's check up on poster sales.
I think we might have.
Yeah, and this circle is on
heel. 10,000.
We should
get 9,800.
So,
I agree.
Wait, so what is
yeah,
that?
How about at 10,000 poster sales, we'll give away a poster that's signed by everybody.
Oh, damn.
We're 176 posters away from 10,000 posters.
Wow.
So we are really close.
Oh, wow.
Did I send you the toolbar?
Yeah.
I have Shopify.
Do you have the link I sent him? I wrote it's like a weird math thing.
I'm like,
I like to see units constantly
refreshing
on the reports page.
Okay, so you're doing the reporting. That's the same thing that I'm doing.
Okay,
yeah,
someone,
we're at 9,820.
Oh, yes, compilation.
Yeah, he does. Pew, pew, pew. Someone said it's not a condor, it's a falcon.
A falcon. It's a
falcon. The
internet
is telling us.
Peregrine
Falcon. I could have just like Googled it at this point, but
no,
it's way more fun to be told.
Let the internet do the work for you.
What are your favorite shows?
They're gonna do it anyway.
It's true.
Oh, favorite show of all time or currently on the air?
It could be both.
So all time is tough because I really, really love the first few episodes or the first few seasons of Dexter, and then Dexter changed. So it went from one of my favorite shows to one of my most hated shows.
Aww.
Wow,
the
ending,
that's it.
The
that
ending and probably the last two seasons specifically of Dexter are.
Yeah,
in my opinion, some of the worst in television.
Oh,
period. In terms of a complete show, Breaking Bad.
Yeah.
For me, it is one of those shows that started strong, maintained strength, even through. And most shows, they have a hard time at like the 3 to 4 year mark where they're trying to figure out. Like,
I've never been so also on edge of my seat during like that mid-season break they had.
Yep.
That was,
was
like
intense.
The most intense cliffhanger I've ever experienced in television.
Yep. And then when it finally ended, it ended the way you kind of knew it was probably gonna have to end that way, and they did it in such a way that it was like, that was good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not angry at the show. I understand what happened. I understand why it happened.
Mm-hmm.
It all made sense. It was perfect closure. Whereas Dexter was in my I don't want to spoil anything, but it should be spoiled. I don't think you should finish that show. It was real bad. At least for me, it was just a really dissatisfying.
No, I've heard that from a few people that it's that way.
And then currently shows on the air. I really like Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Trying to think of something else. Oh, Walking Dead. Walking Dead is tricky because it's really roller coastery.
Mm-hmm.
It'll have like two really, really great episodes, and then there'll be an episode that's just kind of like a supporting episode, for lack of a better explanation.
Yeah,
and
like
those can
up.
Be good, but they can also be kind of boring.
Mm-hmm.
Like they did this thing recently where there was like this giant cliffhanger. And then they told a backstory of one of the other characters for a full episode.
Mm-hmm.
Full extended episode. 90 minutes of backstory on one of the characters. And it was already a character I don't personally identify with. So it's I'm already not really caring about this. And now I get an hour and a half of this character that I don't really care about. So for Walking Dead, a tricky one, just because it's like certain episodes are like, holding on to the ride the whole time, and then it's just like, this is boring.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care about this episode.
Oh, no!
Yeah. I find that especially frustrating when you're binge watching a series, and you're like, this episode, I don't really like it, but now I don't know if I can just skip it and go to the next one and be fine. So, what about anyone else?
What about you, Barb? Favorite show?
Favorite show.
All time.
All time.
Or new.
It's hard because my mind instantly goes to things I've seen within the last couple years.
Yeah.
Even though there were shows I probably enjoyed much more as a kid than I do now.
Come here.
Boy Meets World.
It's gonna sound really lame, but overall, Friends was my favorite show growing up.
It doesn't sound lame at all.
Gavin's all about Friends.
But I think in terms of if I had to choose one, it would be The Simpsons. Because
that's what I was gonna
say.
That
show I could just watch all day, every day, anytime, any episode.
I wasn't allowed to watch Simpsons growing up because my mom thought it was potty TV.
Well, it was one of the only cartoons that was rated TV-14.
Yeah. And when I was a kid, I wasn't allowed to watch it. So when I became an adult, they were in there I think it was 15 or 16th year already.
Yeah.
And I watched it religiously, and then I sort of burnt myself out on it. So that one's always been tough.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I would say mine is my all-time favorite one is The Simpsons, because I didn't really watch Friends at all. And I think my mom let me watch The Simpsons because she thought it was making fun of the U.S. and how ridiculous it was. Because I grew up on purely Australian and British TV.
Your mom is not a fan of America.
No, she's a fan of you though.
Which is great.
So yeah, but for some reason she let us watch The Simpsons. So I really love The Simpsons, but as of new shows, I really like Sunny.
It's Always Sunny.
Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Amazing.
Yeah.
That's all time for me is probably Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
I could watch
How
every
do you feel
episode.
About the new format?
Not a big fan.
Yeah, I think it's fine except for their whole guest thing.
Yeah.
Like it just introduces, and I get the point of it, but it introduces a weird element, like every single time.
Yeah, it's like these people that I don't often recognize, and then they're there for like three games.
Yeah.
Look, I'm gonna run it yeah. your computer.
No thanks.
And then there's the weird game where like Colin just like put shit all over.
What Ryan?
Ryan. And while he's like talking to someone.
Oh yeah.
I just like the game isn't funny.
There's that game. There's one with the new one where they go like through people's purses or something.
Purses one is okay. Oh,
it's pretty funny, but it's weird.
Just because they like some of the items they find are pretty funny.
Yeah.
I feel like that one's got a lot of versatility in that it can be really, really boring and then really, really funny.
Jack, what about you? Oh, sorry.
What's going on?
I didn't realize. I was going to ask Jack what he thought.
Yeah. My favorite show?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Breaking Bad's definitely up there. I love that show. Barbara said they love me, but
they love you more. Well, I would think so with a username like I Love Barbara.
Mm-hmm.
Come here, Rom.
There you go. Yeah, Breaking Bad's pretty incredible.
You're the one that got me into Breaking Bad.
Yeah, I told a lot of people about Breaking Bad.
Jack just wanted someone to watch it with him, because I probably wouldn't watch it with him.
Have to switch from the touch of
mouse. What about like old time favorite? Would you say Boy Meets World? Because
Boy Meets
like...
World is actually up there. As dorky as it is, I actually really love that show. I watched that show a lot when I was a kid.
I would come home and Jack's watching.
So many people angry about me not liking the Morgan episode.
Which one?
The recent Walking Dead episode that I wasn't crazy about was Morgan's episode.
Okay, I haven't watched Walking Dead since like season.
So
three.
He's a character that. Recently has basically, for lack of a better term, has kind of become a little bit of a pacifist. He won't take any life.
Okay.
Which, for me, like I don't identify with that in a post-apocalyptic scenario.
Well, like he won't take any life, like zombie life, or
well, no, he has no problem killing zombies, but he won't kill like.
Oh God!
If someone's attacking him, he won't take their life to protect his own or his family's.
Wow!
Like he'll knock them out. He will in no way like actually kill them. Which like I mean I get it as a core principle, but I don't think that's realistic considering the world scenario. So for me, I don't connect with Morgan. And there are so many people who are mad that I don't like the Morgan episode.
Mark Hamill retweeted us.
Mark Hamill?
Mark Hamill.
Wow.
Whoa.
That's pretty damn cool.
Thank you to Flash Geo.
I hear he's in a movie that's coming out later this year. We should go see it to support him.
He's the Joker. I think I got an exotic angle.
Dude, are you joking?
Yeah. Thank you.
No, we're sad because his avatar is a Simpsons character.
Oh, we've come full circle.
It's true.
Speaking of Whose Line.
What other languages would you recommend for someone to learn to build on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript?
Spanish.
Spanish.
I was actually going to say
that. I'd probably... So it depends on what you want to do. Those three languages you can actually basically build a career on. I would learn a back-end language if you're learning to learn something.
Spanish.
Ruby, Go, PHP... any of the...
Perl. Learn Perl.
Perl's good. Perl's where I started.
I love Perl.
Do you know Perl?
I did. I used to
write in it.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Perl no, it's a Perl jam.
I learned it.
You know regular expressions?
That's maybe.
Kind of the upper end of Perl for some
I was...
What is going on with Rebel?
What is
having a great time.
So he does this. He does this every time I bring Rebel to the office.
No!
Rebel immediately upon getting in the door will bolt, run into the tech office, and if Adam's not there, Rebel will actually whine, and then, and sorry Barbara, will then run to the events office and see if Barbara's there. Barbara's like the
I'm
number
second.
Two. He's like, if Adam's not there, he's like, I'll go see if Barbara's here.
I can't
and if they're both stand. Gone, like Rebel will walk into the middle of the hallway in between our two offices and then just like pout and fall over.
I've never
She's like,
had,
none of my friends are here.
I've never had a dog love me like this.
Oh, look out for the mic. I want to hear what you have to say about Whose Line Is It Anyway.
He does a tour of the office. So he'll like run into animation and talk to like Austin and
really
and the guys over. Yeah, he is.
Yeah.
I'm really sorry, sound guys. He's just killing that mic. Rebel will do like the tour of the office and go like meet and talk all
specifically for what you're trying to do.
Come on. There was a day, Adam, where you were doing a commercial or something with Joel, and I brought Rebel to the office. I bring him inside, and Rebel walked into our office. He weren't there. And then he actually walked around the building, caught your scent outside of Joel's office, and then just like laid down outside of Joel's office. And just like, I know Adam's in there. I'm just gonna wait.
I love having a dog that loves me. It's my favorite.
Sorry, Jack.
I wanted to. I was
so sorry
close.
For your loss.
I know. Nothing quite does it like Rebel's love.
I think the dog's love drinking? In general is just like
Austin East Cider. It's a cider.
It is a cider.
From the
you
east.
You put it inside.
What?
I made that joke already.
Keep pumping
this. Oh, you made that joke already? Oh, sorry. I missed it.
As long as someone left.
Hi, what about you? What's your favorite show? We're answering questions.
Like television?
Like on the television
set. It can be like your favorite of all time or...
Come back to me. I have to think about this for a little bit.
My favorite show is Demo Disc.
Demo Disc.
I saw Kovic in the parking lot.
I took him to there or the airport. The
he apologized for signing me
hotel.
Out
of
Xbox.
Sorry, that sounded really
neat. Did he sign in as you?
Or he walked in front of a Kinect somewhere. I thought Kovic was me.
So, at what point can we talk about things in a television show that could be spoilery?
Right now,
I'd say a season.
A full season?
Yeah.
Well, so depends on the
people,
show.
I've got people
You've
who
got
want Dexter to know my
Coven.
Thoughts
on Walking Dead
on two episodes ago.
Listen,
so I can't talk about it.
I am not.
We had the Star Wars rule when we raided. There was a 2-week window.
You can use
I found out like I found out like 2 days ago that they started a new season of Walking Dead.
Well,
no one's been fucking talking about it.
That's so wrong. Everyone's been talking about it.
I haven't heard shit.
No,
you're apparently not in Slack anymore.
Walking Dead stuff.
Yeah.
I heard they may or may not have killed off a character that I was like, oh, okay. And I really don't give a crap.
That may or may not have happened.
Yeah.
There was a...
Are we, like, supposed to be doing a Wheel of Destiny at any point in time soon?
Wheel of Destiny.
We're doing a thing at 10,000.
How close are we to, like, 190?
Bag.
We're close.
We're at 190. All right, how about... Okay.
Sorry, I was looking at the poster things.
No
Sorry, worries. Guys.
When we get to 190, we'll spin the wheel.
Okay, we're not at 190.
190 coin on him. Spin the wheels.
Oh, damn it.
Look at my guy.
Can he pick me up?
Yeah, look at your guy. Oh.
I was looking away.
Have you not seen him?
There's like a really small image on our store that I tried to zoom in.
Yeah.
This is all I've gotten.
You don't want people to print it. They got to donate.
True. Yeah, we honestly that's the reason why like we don't release a really high resolution version.
Oh,
there was
sorry,
someone on
sorry.
Reddit.
We hit 190.
So
whoa, we hit 190 with a lot.
We didn't publish a high res version.
Yeah.
That happened.
Aww. Here's the 300 DPI version that you can just take to Kinko's.
Make sure it's not muted because that's the one that's supposed to make
We hit 190?
Yeah,
I don't think it was muted.
Hey.
Would you like to spin the wheel, Adam?
Yes.
We only have
but I've also been checking the donations, so
does it matter?
All right, spin the wheels. Make sure you land on something. If you don't land anything, you'll spin it again.
I like that some of them are referencing people who aren't here.
Yeah, no, we updated it.
We didn't reset it when
I just saw Josh Flanagan as a push-up with Barbara.
He's still here.
There's blank ones.
Josh Flanagan's right behind
you. Oh, there he is. Hi, Josh.
Spin it again.
What fell off?
Marker.
All right, and so we should make one of them dogfight.
So you promise there's no cats up for grabs this time?
There's no cats up for grabs this time. Barb makeover. Oh, Barbara's gonna make someone over.
Wait, no, Barbara gets a makeover.
No, it was me give someone.
No, she gets to pick someone.
I think it'd be fun if you did Barbara's makeup though, because I watched that video and it was hilarious.
Shut your mouth, cat.
Do it.
Do we have makeup?
No,
I don't want to ruin your makeup.
That whole Adam Hall's like, you got a makeover.
I don't want to ruin your makeup.
I've already gotten a makeover. This is old news.
Very good at makeup. I'm
then
sure
you went
she could,
got, like,
she
waffles
could fix
waffles
it.
Or something.
I'm only okay on myself.
Right. So if he did yours, you could like take it off and do your own again, right?
There you go. So you get to do Barbara's makeup.
Yay!
All right. I'm the makeup artist now.
All right. And we are. How many posters are we at sold?
I think we're getting close
we're,
to 10,000.
We're getting really
we are literally one away.
We have 9,999 posters sold.
Wait for it.
Yeah,
I'm just
we
refreshing.
Are. We
oh,
need
God.
One more poster.
Someone buy a poster
we're
for the love of God.
999.
And we're going to
give... One and two.
Hey, there we go.
We're sold. 10,000. Oh, two.
Hey, did you buy two?
Yeah, I bought two.
All right, sweet. Yeah. Thank you very much, Tyler.
Tyler, we said you could buy one.
Damn it, Tyler.
Posters aren't limited, by the way, so
you
can,
yeah,
you
can buy
as many
as you want.
As you want.
We print them on demand.
Except Tyler.
Absolutely.
Except Tyler.
Send
cool.
out all the goddamn...
That room.
What kind of...
I don't know where our makeup is.
Are we doing it like on screen camera, though?
I guess so.
We're going
here.
Cool.
I'll go get it.
Oh, God.
I can't find the donation layers. Thing if we, now.
Oh, is it?
The intermission?
Okay, what time is it? Oh, it is 4.
So
okay.
We're giving away the poster.
It's like, looks like a little blue bag.
Here, you want to play this for a second?
Oh, yeah.
Here. Anyway.
I think we should go to intermission.
Holy shit.
Should we?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, God, I'm standing on
stage.
What are you playing, Adam?
Huh?
What are you playing?
I'm playing Jack. I'm going to dismantle all his guns.
Oh, you're playing Destiny.
Yes.
Are they here yet? Oh, Ryan.
I'm going to do what I did. I'm going to dismantle my 310 artifact. Oh, right. Now I can't get another one.
Oh, did you really do that?
Ryan,
let's see. We can get rid of Sleeper.
Adam.
Look, it's everybody's
favorite.
Oh, yeah, no, get rid of this sword. Look, you got the exotic sword. Break that down immediately. Look, it's everybody's favorite Ryan.
It's no
work to get another one.
He's got Black Spindle. Oh, we could do Touch of Malice. Oh, no, it's not. You can't break that one down. Oh, maybe.
You can?
No, you can.
You can. Absolutely.
We can break down Dismantle.
That's a good one, yeah.
We can get rid of his
Internet. Nah, he just bought that one.
We're gonna take a short little break. Thank you for watching so far. But this will be a chance for you to get away, kind of stretch your legs, get some water, get some fruit or something along those lines. If you go to roosterteeth.com/donate, it takes you to our donation page, and we are looking to raise money. We're over $190,000 already. So thank you very, very much, everyone who has donated. We're also selling posters as well. We just broke 10,000 posters sold. We're looking to get to 25,000. So we are very, very close. We are very much on our way. 40% there, which is fantastic. So we're going to take a quick little break and you can kind of reset over here, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. So thank you for watching. We'll see you in a few.
Thank you. I have a few $100 donations. It might be funnier.